Hi, this is Daniel Ransom, Instructional Services Librarian at CCA, and this is a follow-up video about doing captions using YouTube to automatically generate captions that for videos that you then upload to Moodle or VoiceThread. So in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to upload the video and captions that you've generated in YouTube into Moodle. So if you still need the instructions on how to actually get the automatically generated captions in YouTube, you'll want to go ahead and watch my other video. So here you'll see that I'm already logged into a demo course that I have in Moodle. So any Moodle course that you have would look similar to this. You would follow the same procedure. So I'm in my demo course and I'm going to turn editing on. So now with editing on, obviously I have more options and more features, more places I could add something. So I'm going to go down to the bottom of this course and I am going to add an activity or resource. I could add the video a number of different ways. I could add it as part of an assignment. I could add it as part of a list of resources. There's of course many different ways that you can add content in Moodle. For this, because I'm just going for a simple approach, I'm going to add it as a label. Label's kind of an odd term in Moodle. What it really means is just put something straight on the page as opposed to somebody having to click through to get to an assignment or to get to a file. It just places it directly on the Moodle course page. So I'm gonna click label and add. And now I get a text box. So you could add a video in any form of a text box, and you see these same text box under assignments and other under things. So this is the same process you would follow no matter what type of or place that you're choosing to add the video. So I click on the icon where it says insert or edit an audio slash video file. I'm adding a video, and then I'm going to browse repositories, and this is going to give me a chance to upload a file from my computer hard drive. So here I have in my downloads the file that I have already uploaded and edited in YouTube. And I'll give it a name. And upload this file. This will usually take a moment, depending on how large the video file. Sometimes it can actually take quite a few minutes. This happens to be a pretty short video, so it's already successfully uploaded. Now, the next thing I want to do is open this subtitles and captions option. So this is where I'll be able to add the separate file that contains the captions for my video. So actually, I don't want subtitles, I want captions. Browse repositories, choose file, and here is my captions file. Now, captions can come in a variety of different file formats. I talked about that a little bit in my last video. Moodle only accepts the VTT format for captions, so you'll want to make sure that is the file type that you've downloaded. So I choose my file. I'll give it a specific name. And now I can hopefully insert my media, and there is the video. I could add introductory text or other elements. I can still do other things, but I'm just gonna leave it. I'm gonna hit save and return to course. So that'll save my work. And now here's my video right here on the homepage of my course. If I go back and turn editing off, I'll see it similarly to how a student might see it. There's a play button. I can hit play on my video and you'll see that there's a closed caption feature, and I can choose to turn those captions on and they will appear with the video. Somebody could go full screen and watch the video on full screen if they wanted. So that's the basics of how you would upload your captions to your Moodle course along with the video file. The main thing to remember is that they do become separate files, the video file and the captions file, and you just need to make sure that you're uploading both of them. But Moodle does have that built-in feature where it gives you a place to put that that captions file. We'll also make a video around how to do this in VoiceThread, because you'll want to use VoiceThread to host your videos if that video file is over 1.6 gigabytes, but under 3. If it's larger than that, we'll need to figure out how to make your video smaller, probably by breaking it into to individual parts so that it's not so big a file. If you have any questions, of course, always check in with us at helpdesk@cca.edu. Great. Thank you.